everyone, and thank you for watching Fast React tutorials. In this quick tutorial, we will showcase an update on our sticker tutorials and go over on how to easily apply stickers in Substance Painter. Now here we have these boxes, and I already have an atlas with all of our stickers on it. What we are going to do first is we are going to single out our stickers and create a new document that we will make 1024 by 1024. And then what we can do is we can go ahead and we can select our stickers. Then we can press Ctrl copy, go to our new document, and press Ctrl V. Then we can press Ctrl T to transform our sticker and make it a little bit bigger. And don't forget to hold Shift to uniformly scale it. Here we go. Next, what I want to mention is that you can export and import textures without a background, and it will just work in Substance Painter, but it's not needed. So what we do now is create a mask. We can go ahead and create a solid color and then we will duplicate our layer over here. Once that is done, move the layer above your color, right click and go to blending options and then click on color overlay and make sure that the color is set to white for a quick mask. Now that is done, we have our label and our mask, and we can start by exporting this file by going to file, save as a copy, and we want to go ahead and save this as a PNG file. So I will just go ahead and call this label _01 and just press OK. And now to save a mask, we will turn off our label, save as a copy. Label _01_A or mask or whatever you prefer. Next, we will import our labels in the Painter. Just go to File and Import Resources, or you can just drag and drop. Next, let's import our files and set them to texture and import them for this project. Then what you want to do is select the label and simply drag it in your model and click on base color. So this is a new technique where you can just drag it on. You can use W, E and R to move, rotate and scale. And now we are going to apply our mask. We can do it by going to our texture set settings, user channel, user 0. And then what we can do in our labels is we can activate user 0 and apply our mask. And what we want to do is create an anchor point. We are going to recall this anchor point in a black mask on the same layer. And then what you want to do in your fill layer is select the anchor point and set the reference channel to user 0. Next, we can move our layer into position by just going ahead and select our layer. Again, you can use W, E and R to just move it wherever you want it to be. So let's move it and scale it up a bit by pressing R. I was a bit picky about scale, but here we go. And now if you want to go ahead and add a very easy height and roughness thanks to our mask, we can do this. So let's grab a better angle over here. So for our height, because our user 0 is references in our mask, we can instantly add a height without needing to do any type of new masking, which is new compared to our old version of doing things. So we can set a height and we can do the same with our roughness or any other channels. It will only affect our stickers like you can see over here. Now, next, what we are going to do is we are going to show you how to add some damage. You can very easily do this by adding a paint on top of a mask, grabbing a simple brush, make sure the brush is set to black, and just pick a nice scale of it. And then, as you can see, we can just paint in some additional damage over here. So that is very easy to just quick add some damage and have it apply everywhere. Now, next, my height is a little bit too strong, so let's go back, adjust the height a little bit until you got something you like, but feel free to change it however you want. Now, as a quick little bonus, I'm going to show you how to paint in some more simplified version using our atlas over here. Make sure that the atlas doesn't have background because this technique will not work. So we can just go ahead and we can already import this atlas, and you can of course create your own, for example. So let's add this to texture project and let's go ahead and simply import it. And now if we just go ahead and just use the other side of the box for this example over here. Now, what you want to do is you want to create a new plane layer, turn off everything but color, go to your projection mapping and drag in your label into the base color and just turn the rest off. And once that is done, you can use S and then you can use your mouse button to rotate, scale, and move the projection. And then you can simply paint it wherever you want to have the specific details. The nice thing about this technique is that you can also use it with color. It doesn't have to be just black. So we can, for example, grab like a label that has some color on it over here, and we can also paint that in. However, you will not have the flexibility of height and roughness in this. Now that this is done, what we can do is we can go ahead and we can add some extra variation by adding a black mask along with a fill layer, and then simply grab some type of grunge map, throw it into the fill layer, and use your balance and your contrast, and of course your tiling, to add some general variation to our text over here. And that was about it for this quick tutorial. I hope that this tutorial helps you, and I hope to see you next time.